Hello everybody, welcome back to Kona. I'm Mr. Chento and today the story continues. Now, I'll admit, I can't really remember where we left off. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at the map. I've got a rough idea where I am. Yeah, we're down at Roy's house. Did we search everything in here? I'm not entirely sure if we did or we didn't. I'll just have a quick look around. I think we did. I remember the layout of the house. Yeah, I remember this is where all the book pages and everything were, wasn't it? Right, okay. So, what we're wanting to do, I believe, there we go, is we looked at the Bedards, we looked at the Roys. I think we'll go up to that Blay. I don't think we can get to Old Rosary or anything like that, because I think we can only go as far as the Doctors. I'm not sure how far we can go up the way, but I believe there's some sort of mining camp or something up this way. Did we look in there? I think we did. Yeah, we did. Right, so what we're going to do is head out that way. What way's the front door? All the doors look the same. Was this a good guess? It was. Yeah, okay. You're under stress. And he's still got his engine running from last time. So what we want to do, where's the buttons? We want to head out left and just keep going left past the general store, first left past the general store itself, and then we'll do the treasure hunt, I think. Maybe, I don't know. I'm a little bit lost at the moment, so we'll see. Right, here's the main road. We've worked that much out. So the story continues. I think we're still trying to work out basically what the hell happened. Oh, bump. Yep, there we go. Thankfully, we know we're out here on our own, and we can get away with looking at the map while we're driving. As long as we don't hit a tree. But it's always a possibility. Right, here's the general store with the tree down. So what we want to do is turn in here. Turn back out here. There we go. Right, hold on. We want to look at the map again, don't we? Oh, we're going the wrong way. We want to go slightly right and then up. Do we? Oh, I'm totally lost here. Totally and utterly lost. I don't think we want to go up there. Where the hell are we going? Because everywhere it's trying to take us up to the Doctors. Oh no, is that the Doctors up there? Then we want to go this way. Right. I think I've worked it out. Well, clearly I've worked it out because it's blown in a new area. Right. So yeah, we don't... Hold on, there's... Oh, the transmission in this thing. Right. Let's see. It looks like there's a walker's path or something up the right-hand side. And for some reason, the truck's just not moving. There we go. We'll stick to the original plan and we'll look for the house first. Wow, the snow's getting worse, if anything. Right, here's a fence. Oh, hold on. Step out. Let's have a look at the mailbox. Always check the mailbox. And there's nothing in it. Well, that's a first. Right, so where's the... Let's have a look. Hold on. I'm still a bit lost. Right. So there's the walker's path up there. That's might be the old mine. Or is that the mine up there? And this here looks like it should be a town. And there's the Hamilton's house. I don't know how far up there we can go. But let's have a look at the house first. We're here, we might as well look. And as it loads in another tile, come on now. There we go. Ooh, that's an interesting looking place. Look at the pile of rocks. Anyway, here's the house. He's got a little outhouse there. Let's have a look though. And again, he doesn't switch his engine off. That's annoying me. I wish the developers would do something about that.
A wintry atmosphere surrounded the house. The soundlessness of the area suggested it was empty.
Right. We're 3 episodes in, and you've basically just realised that not only is it wintry, but there's no one here. Oh, you're not a bright boy, are you? Okay. A boot.
When finding a boot, one wonders what became of the foot.
Or the other boot, you know. That could be worth looking into as well. The windows are frozen. That's quite cool. Quite a cool effect they've got on the window, look. It's quite realistic. What was that noise? I definitely heard a howl in there. And the lights are on. Hello? Okay. This is quite creepy. Someone ran out of packing. Yeah, I would say they ran out. Let's get a fire started. Get some heat.
The key, which seemed to be meant for a padlock, bore an inscription reading Clutze Efis. A company name. Better keep an eye open. Businesses weren't exactly numerous around these parts.
Right, okay, so we've got a padlock key for something.
Money in a jar.
Come on, take it.
What a shame. Carl would have loved cookies.
I just take the money. You can buy cookies somewhere else. Nothing in there. We don't want to turn the radio on. Why was it telling me to aim the gun? Hold on, open. I think that's what's stopping me getting in. There we go. I keep hearing squeaks and it's quite worrying. I'm actually a bit freaked out in this house. There's another steak. I don't like the look through that. Just saying. What's that?
Pay stub.
Pay stub, okay.
For some undoubtedly harsh lumberjack work. Alexandre Blais felled trees and chopped woods for Cloutier et Fils.
Anything on the table?
The spirograph amused Carl. It was a nice modern toy. Aside from being repetitive by nature and completely useless. Still, it found its way into many Quebecois homes.
Okay, yeah, I noticed that had been moved. So what's this? A note from Martin Blais. Please excuse my handwriting, I'm in a hurry. Well, judging by how you left the house, that's no surprise. I have to leave for North Manston with Mum and Mrs. Roy, as they say it's far too dangerous around here these days. I don't know much about what's going on because Mum won't tell me anything and I attempt to reassure me, but all I know is she has the exact same expression on her face as when I startle her. Dad and Mr. Roy aren't coming because they have gone to get Mr. LaChance. They're real heroes. My grandmother lives in a very big house in North Manston and you would be welcome there. Okay, so North Manston is a town. And of course, the phone line's dead. Yeah, this is creepy. The bulb's out. Nothing. 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 Fire starter. Is that something we can use? Yeah, it is. Painkillers. A broken mirror. Lovely. Oh, something on the back of the toilet. A bit of reading. Ugh. Nothing important. There's just something bugging me about this place. I can't explain it. It's just, it feels like a panic has been here. Okay, let's go. So no lights or anything around here. Oh, the creak on the floor. A new journal entry. No reason to scare me or anything with the static on the TV or, you know, the usual horror things.
The sheets were in such a way that indicated a rude awakening, followed by a hurried escape. What had happened here?
I'm not entirely sure I want to know, to tell you the truth. Le Monster. Okay. The only reassuring thing about that is the fact that there's pictures of wolves. Right. Anything over here? Cigarettes and everything, it's nothing exciting. A diary. I fear the worst for Alexandre, hardly gets any sleep, da da da. Again, you can read that, if you want to pause it and read it. Okay. Nothing in there. So there's nothing too concerning, as it turns out. Okay. A wolf, thank God. Yeah, that wasn't at all scary. Whew, right. It was nice that the wolf shut the door on. Yeah, and it also didn't leave any paw prints. That was quite an awakening. That. Okay, so we don't have the key for that. Can we not just shoot the lock? Apparently not. All right. Oh, hold on.
A key. What could it be for?
I wonder if that's the key.
The garden shed?
Hey!
Carl couldn't reach it with his arm alone. But he had more than a few tricks up his sleeve to pick it up.
Okay, what do we have in here? Flares. Why would we need flares? Oh. No, I want that hardware. Nothing. That looks like it should be something, but it's not. A hammer, yeah, okay. A chainsaw, can we take it? Fire starters, good. An empty gas can. Alright, so I wonder if we can go back and get gas and then use that for the chainsaw. Interesting. We know what's there. Let's have a quick look around the area. Doesn't look like there's much back here. Always, we can put it that way, we're outside. Always search the rubbish bin. Ah, inventory is full. A deck chair, because why wouldn't you want to sit out in this? But there's nothing else too sort of worrying around here. So what we'll do, we're now clear, we can tick this off our list. Let's deposit. Right, what do we want to deposit? The gas can. We've already got an empty bottle on us. We'll put a couple of the steaks away. Matches. We'll leave them on us. We need them. We'll put one thing of hardware away. Yeah, that'll do for just now. Okay, I'm away to go and look at this. There's nothing really, it's just a pile of rocks, isn't it? Okay. So where are we wanting to head to next? Apart from out of here, this is getting quite creepy. Okay, so there's a shack down there. So we want to turn right and then left when we get out of here. Let's go and look at the shack. Nope, that's out of that. Thank you. Even the way that's swaying around is a bit creepy. I'll be glad to get in my truck. There we go. Right, so right then left, was it? Yeah, right then left. Let's see, where's the turn off? Up there. And it's loading a new area. I wish it wouldn't do that, it kind of breaks the immersion of the game. Private terrain. Can we just drive into it? Yeah, we can't, it's fine. The woodlots. Okay, there's lots of footprints around here. Cabin A. Right. I'm going to keep my gun ready here. They're paw prints. Can we take that axe?
An axe. A hatchet. Not too shabby. Carl felt he needed to protect himself.
All right.
It was a typical shack, just like the ones you hear about in Quebecois legends. Local lumberjacks used it to rest and twice a day heat up their pea soup. Who quits a game one step away from victory?
Someone who had to get the hell out of here. We don't need a fire at the moment, we're fine. Yeah, it's a little bit wet down there. Anything in the bin? Some cigarettes? Nothing else. Right, let's get out of here. These paw prints are a little bit concerning. Let's follow them for a little bit and see what we've got. Okay, so they run up over the wood. And for some... Oh, hold on. We'll have a look in the bin. Empty bottle. No use. Okay, so here's where the paw prints are going. I'm not too sure I want to follow this.
It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore.
Okay, flaming arrow. Oh. Out of here. Come on. Well, that worked. I actually didn't see them till the last second.
The crossbow bolts had the same origin. Carl was sure of it. Who was it? And more importantly,
picture taken. There we go.
Being hunted like this.
We'll keep that picture. Can we start a fire? Yep, we can. That'll get our heat up. Fire starter replaced. We don't need the magnet. Got the matches, that's fine. Steaks. Which we can also use for the wolves. So where are we in terms of map? We are out my... Yeah. So I think if we get back to the truck and go straight up, we can go into the shack itself. So we'll just follow the footprints back, because we know that'll lead us back to our truck. I've lost the footprints. Right, there they are. There we go, find them. Anything around here? We'll get a plank of wood, seeing as we used the last one on that fire. Right. It's getting creepier. It is. It's starting to heat up the game. Pun intended. Let's see what we can find up here. There should be a little turn off towards the shack. Yeah, we're nowhere near it yet. Right, let's see. Oh, is that it? Brakes are bad on this, is that in the Ferndale in my summer car? Right. Yep, that's it. That's the turn off we're looking for. And there's the shack. Perfect. Right. Out. I don't know, we just feel a little bit isolated out here. And the windows are broken, look. Are they? No, there's just something on inside. Fair enough. They look broken from a distance. Unlock, so we had the keys.
Welcome to Alibaba's cave. Lumberjack edition.
Okay, lots
Surely
of fire starters.
Carl would find something worth his time in here.
Should be able to, but hardware. A lantern. That's probably better than the torch. Nothing. Matches. Nothing. It would be too cumbersome to carry around, yeah, but I don't particularly care about that. Tool shed, no. Don't forget to return the key for the cabin if you have to use it. Is that important in any way? Polaroid film. There's forest cabin key. I should be able to take that though. I don't need to carry it around, I could throw it in the back of the truck. More flares, yeah. That's a bit worrying. I don't see why we would need flares. Is there nothing else in here? I really want that chainsaw. I really do want it. Oh well, right. Let's have a quick look around out here, see what we can see. Oh dear, I see more blue blocks of ice. And footprints. Sort of pointing up there. It's just a brazier heater thing. Not really much use. Right. Map. Let's have a quick look again. So, cabin. But we already had that. Or is it just trying to say cabin A? Right, okay. So I'm guessing we need to now go down to cabin B. Nope. Turning in circle on this thing. Right, there we go. Right, and we want to go up here, don't we? Let's see what's up here. Oh, there's a cabin up there. I see more burning flames. I see arrows. Not particularly good.
Carl was becoming increasingly convinced that this was not normal hunting. The game that was being tracked was fearsome. So much so that the hunter didn't dare approach it. What could it be?
Changing the film. Can we get in?
Without a single window to brighten things up, the inside of the cabin was almost pitch black. Beware of close encounters of meat and furniture.
Inventory full, okay. I think we've got a lot of crap here that we can get rid of. Deposit. We don't need all these flares. We'll keep a couple on us. We'll leave that. We'll throw the empty bottles away. We'll throw another stake in the boot. We'll throw one first aid kit in the back. One more hardware. And the hatchet. And the hammer. We know they're in there if we need them. Right. I see more footprints. Switch that off. Okay. What do we have?
Solitaire. A card game only hermits
can truly
enjoy.
Flare again. Cigarettes.
Carl felt depressed at the thought of playing this.
Anything around? Nothing. Nothing. For some reason that thing flares, just not going away. Toothbrush is still wet, so has someone just done a runner?
Everything was set up for a well-deserved snack. It seemed like the place hadn't been empty for long, but without knowing exactly why, Carl had the feeling no one was coming back anytime soon.
Yep, I would say that's probably a good guess. Right, okay, so yeah, I was just in cabin A, cabin B. So I'm not quite sure what's wanting us to do. Is that the more wood cabins up there? Maybe we should go up there and have a look. Yeah, let's go up and have a look at the other cabins. No, it doesn't let you get out the map very easily. Is there anything up here? Oh, there's bins to search. Was that fire starter? And nothing. Oh, there's a chest round the back. Another steak. I'm guessing that's painkillers. Let's run back to the truck. We'll search the footprints in a second. Deposit. Oh yeah, and we'll throw another first aid kit in the back. Throw some cigarettes in the back. And matches. I think that'll do. There we go, the logs appear in the back, but... okay. Where was the footprints that we saw? There they are. And then they go down and round. And down into the forest part.
Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold.
And then do they continue? Right. Straightforward. Are they just heading back to the same point? They might be. Did we already do that one? Don't think we did. Uh-oh. Go. Whew, I did not see them again. Not ideal. What's that? Empty bottle, we don't want it. We've got some. Let's start a fire. The really annoying thing is, whenever that happens, it's always when you've got, when the guy's really cold or something like that. Carl's cold and then he puts his hands together. And then you can't respond to get your gun out. He's too busy being cold to care about a way of being eaten by wolves. I mean, he needs to get his priorities straight. Right. Let's get back to the truck. And let's go and search the other cabins. Come on. I think he's needing a cigarette. Yeah, he's not able to run very far now. Okay, Carl, I'll get you a cigarette. No, that's not what I'm on. No, wrong button again. Consumable cigarette.
Carl, like many of his contemporaries, felt like he had more trouble breathing when he wasn't smoking. Cigarette was his own personal breathing assistant.
So where are we going now? Straight out of here and right. Yeah, I think that's where we're going. I think it is. It's... Okay, we'll just go with it. No, straight out again, left. No, right, right. Definitely right. Right, there's the cabin A. Let's have a look in this trailer, quickly, before we freeze our arse off. Anything here? Duct tape. Oh, what's that? Hardware. Empty bottles we don't need. Other than that, nothing important, impressive, whatever you want to say. There is a toy giraffe there, which is a bit creepy. And now we can't go over there, okay. So we want to go, let's just get this straight in our head. Right, and then there should be like a little walker's dirt path. Okay, is that a lookout tower up there too? Something tells me we better wait to start encountering a lot more wolves, because we're going to have to do a lot more on foot. Which is nice, I guess. Right, let's just keep following that. We're not too far away from it. And it's loading a new area. There we go, it was quick. It's fine. Okay. There's been a landslide and a car with smoke coming out the back of it. That's worrying.
The track was fresh. That meant the car sunk down just a little while ago. Now where the hell could the passengers possibly have gone?
Anything in your...
until that point, Carl had believed that the object of this crop...
Another lone boot. So that was the people from the house that went, that we found earlier with the boot outside.
As he noticed the height at which the bolts had been fired, he concluded that the beast had to have been as tall as a man on his feet, not unlike a gorilla. The thought was chilling.
I swear I just heard something there. No. Put that away. There we go. Nothing, nothing. Okay.
There was only void where the road should be. Carl hated dead ends. He felt trapped. It was as if the road had drowned in the lake. He would have to find help by another road.
All right, so it looks like we're going this way. What's this? Wilfred Roy, yeah, that would make sense.
Someone must have dropped this in a hurry, but whoever did was heading into the woods. Carl's tracking instincts were quickly kicking in.
There's lots of paw prints again, more blue ice, which is... Yeah. A recurring theme for us. Okay, the footprints
Carl
are saying up.
How long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold.
Oh, stop complaining, man. Let's just follow these tracks. Ice wall. Oh.
Carl knew why he was suddenly shivering. He was going back to the realm of visions.
Okay, there's people over here.
Carl had no issue recognizing the spirit-like figures.
I'm glad you don't.
Figure out what they wanted from him. The phantom, freed of reality's shackles, vanished in the forest. Earlier, Carl had witnessed the tragedy that befell it.
Okay. So So they're wanting us to find more characters, are they? Alright, so can we walk away from the wall then?
Carl sensed that the cold was beating a retreat, as if he was moving away from some kind of center of gravity.
Okay, that wasn't scary. Oh, there's a box here. Okay, it's another map, number 4. We haven't done number 1 yet, so... where are we? Where the hell are we? That's a good point. Okay, so we've reached an ice wall when we get to there, and we can't get any further because of the landslide. The only way forward would be on foot. So what way around are we going from here? Is there anything around here? Right, so that way we lead straight back. So we want to go sort of this way. And hope it kind of leads out. Right, there we go. This is where we were. So if that's the landslide, we need somewhere to light a fire. No, we don't want that.
Cold turned into pain. Carl needed to find someplace warm.
Yeah, well, I'm trying my best. Would our truck help? There we go, he's warming up in the truck. I'll admit, I'm struggling at the moment. Let's see. We can't go any further there. We can't seem to get past that. I think he's struggling a bit here. Hold on. We're still low on heat. We're still high on health, though. We just need somewhere to light a fire. So let's turn back. I don't think there's much we can do here. Yep, okay, Carl, I know you're struggling. I'm struggling to work out where to go from here. Because we've searched all that. See, we really need to search up there, but we can't really get any further. So I think what we're going to have to do is go on the treasure hunt. But I think what we're needing right now is just somewhere warm. Yeah, so let's go. Let's go and get some heat in the cabin. Load if you want, that would be good. Just in here, I'll do it. Because we're in desperate times here, so desperate measures are required. Right. What are we short of? a log. Oh well, but lucky we're in a lumberjack yard, isn't it?
The leftover food, the clothes, the general warmth of the place, no evidence of escape. Carl was sure of it. People were here not long ago.
There we go, he's warming up nicely now.
To come back.
So yeah, I think that will do us for today, and next time we'll go on a treasure hunt, and hopefully next time the full game, or at least more of the game, should be released, so we'll be able to go and investigate all the houses around the back of the doctor's bit and everything like that, which will hopefully help us progress on towards the town. So I hope you enjoyed today's episode. It certainly got a little bit creepier with all the wolves out and about and a few little jump scares. So, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.